Walmart. The Rising of Walmart by Chelsea Watson. In the late 40s and early 50s, the people of Arkansas saw the economy shifted from a military emphasis to a consumer-driven one. Sam Walton was born in 1918 in Oklahoma. When Walton was just 24, he joined the military. He married a lady named Helen Robinson in 1943. In 1945, when he finished serving his time in the military, he and his wife moved to Arkansas. In 1950, Sam and Helen Walton purchased Luther Harrison's Variety Store and turned it into a Five and Dime store, which is a Ben Franklin franchise with the Waltons' name. They were there for 5 years, and in just 3 years, they grew profits grew sales from just $80,000 to $225,000. They were so successful that the lease owner wanted to take their property back and give it to his son. Walton opened 14 of these Five and Dime stores, which these are what they look like, between 1951 and 1962. After becoming Ben Franklin's largest franchisee, Sam opened his first large discount store under the Walmart name in Rogersville, Arkansas. It was less than one-fifth the size of today's Walmart's and only had 25 employees. Sam Walton was so impressed with his store, how it was running, he made a trip to the Ben Franklin offices in Chicago to share his idea. He had a belief that the discount stores would thrive in a small rural market town that people ignored with populations of 5,000 or less. And if you sold products at the cheapest price possible, and in turn, profits would rise. This basically meant that by cutting your price, you can boost your sales to a point where you can earn far more at a cheaper retail price than you would have by selling the item at a higher price. After thinking it over, the Franklin brothers basically declined. Sam Walton was an entrepreneur who could not find backers for his dream of a discount mega chain, so he decided to go at it alone. 2 years later, in 1964, he opened his second Walmart in Harrison, Arkansas. It was a disaster, but each day was an improvement. On October 31st, 1969, Walmart was incorporated. In the spring of 1971, Walmart stock had its first 100% split and was sold at a market price of $47. This was the first Walmart. In 1972, Walmart was listed on the New York Stock Exchange. The initial shares were $100 by the end of 1989, the shares were well worth over $1 million. In the 70s, Walmart grew in a lot of different ways. From 60,000 square foot distribution centers in Bentonville, Arkansas, to 24 centers that were 1.5 million square feet, and at that time, 3,500 employees. In 1978, Walmart opened its first pharmacy, auto service, and jewelry division. In 1979, a milestone was reached. Walmart had hit its first billion-dollar year. The 80s had a new and improved concept. These years were all about experimenting. In the 1980s, Walmart continued to expand across the U.S. and also became the fastest company to reach $1 billion in sales. In 1987, they completed the largest private satellite communication system in the U.S., which links all operating units of the company with the general office. By 1988, Walmart moved on to an even bigger project and opened its first supercenter. Walmart became the nation's top retailer and was recognized as an icon of an American ingenuity. By 1991, Walmart on the international market opened its first Walmart outside of U.S. lines in Mexico City. In 1992, President Bush traveled to Walmart headquarters in Bentonville, Arkansas, and awarded Sam Walton the Medal of Freedom, which is the nation's highest civilian honor. Weak with cancer, He stood and got his medal, knowing he only had less than a month to live. On April 5th, 1992, Sam Walton passed away at age 74. People thought since Walton passed, it would have a devastating effect on the company. Once again, they proved people wrong. After his passing, Walton's oldest son, Rob Walton, became chairman of the board of Walmart. By 1995, Walmart made it to cover all 50 states. Now, there are more than 8,500 stores around the world, 2.1 million workers, and more than 200 million customers visit the store weekly. Till this day, Walmart still thrives. And this is Walmart's many years of logos. The first one, the blue, is from 1962 to 1964. This was their very first one. The bottom two were from 1964 to 1981, and they switched those out. They were used for the year for both of them. The brown one was from 1981 to 1992. The middle one is from 1992 to 2008. And the last one is 2008, and it is our present Walmart logo. Thank you. Have a blessed day.